Yeah, good evening. In the previous session, we discussed some of the concepts related to classes, objects, and methods. Now, you are going to know about the some of the concepts related to the classes. Under the classes, you are going to know about the what is a constructor. After that, you will discuss about the inheritance and then polymorphism. Here, what is a class exactly? Class is a collection of objects. Class is a collection of objects. This particular class consists of attributes and methods. The class consists of attributes as well as the methods. That means you can define the methods, you can represent the different methods in certain way. That is a simple representation of class. In the previous session, you discussed so many information regarding the class. What is a class? The class, class name, and then you can represent the different statements. That means the statements may be a, it's may you can define the variables, you can define the some other information, some functions, you can define the some functions like that, you can define any number of values for the class. Okay, after that, the next important thing, you discuss these concepts, class, object, and then method. That means if you represent the, for example, if you represent the anything under the class, any function, that's called here method. For example, I'm going to write in simple class here. How can I write the simple class? For example, the class, class name. You may take the any class and day. For example, class, class name. I am taking the student class. Student, for example, student class. I am representing the student class. Under the student class, I am taking the ID is a one variable. ID equal to some, you can represent any ID name. And then, for example, name equal to another variable, you can represent Uma is a some name. These are all are the some of the variables. After that, I can define the some function. You may take the any function and D. For example, you may take the display function, you may take the some other function, you may take any, that means whatever work of student, the student can do, can write something. For example, I am taking the writing, write something. That means if you apply the write, if you apply the name of the method, or write one, name of the method, that method always takes a one parameter and in. The parameter is a self parameter. Already you discussed that concept about the self. What is the self parameter? Already you discussed that concept. Self is used to refer the instance of a class to the method. Here I am using the self here. Instance of a class to the method. This particular method, write one method. This is an example. Instance of a class to the method that represents a self. That represents the self. Okay. This is a particular self method. And then under the self method, I am writing something here. For example, simple representation, I am taking the every time I print something, yeah, student work. That means these are all, this is a simple representation about the class. Simple representation about the class. After that, that means the first initially you create the class. After that, you create a some method. Under the method, why it is a method? Why? Because there is a self parameter is there. And then second important thing, you will create a function under the class. That's why you call it as a method. That's why you call it as a, this is called here method. Any function declared under the class, that is called, indicates the method. Here, how can you call this particular particular class? You can call this particular class by using, you can use a object. How can you create the object? Very important thing, creation of object for the class. Creation of object. How can you create the object? That means you can take the any variable, you can take the any object. That means you, and then you have to give a class name. Here, what is the class name? Student. And then open parenthesis, close parenthesis. This is a way, that means indicates that after creation of object only you can allocate the memory for the this particular class. Before that you cannot allocate a memory for that one. Here it can allocate some memory, like for example after applying the this object only you can allocate some memory. That is indicates that instance with that object only you can access any value, either you can access the variable. For example, with the object o dot you can take the name, o dot name, you can get o dot for example id, and then you can get it the, that means any name, anything here you can get with the help of this id and class name. I think is it clear for you? This is a and previously you discussed that concept. If you execute this one, you can execute no problem with the help of no. Here, if you want more information, I need some details here. You can print that one. Here, print that value, then it can print. For example, print name, it can print the value. Okay, Uma. For example, if you want to print the ID, you can print the ID. O dot ID. O dot ID. Yeah. That means you can execute this one. It will print the all information. Similarly, you can get the similar way. You can write this. For example, I want to access that this particular method. How can I access this particular method here? You can access O dot write one. Then you can execute this one. That means anything here you can access this particular value from this one. That is a simple information. Now in this session you are going to know about the constructors. What is a constructor? What is the way of declaring the constructor? What are the special information regarding the constructor? Here constructor, what is a constructor? That means in Java or C++ constructor is a special method. Okay, in Java or something somewhere else, anywhere, constructor is a special method. The constructor name same as the class name. In the Java and then C++, constructor name same as the class name. This is a particular method. This method is used to creating the class variables. For creating the class variables, you will use this particular method. Okay, that is a constructor. Here in Python here, what is the constructor here? Here you can create the constructor by using underscore underscore init method. Underscore underscore init is a one method. Underscore underscore init is a one method, a special method. Which by using this method, you can create the constructor. You can create the constructor. You by using constructor, you can create the instance variables. You can create the automatically. You can create the instance variable. I can tell you. That means how can you create the instance variable, or how can you do that one? And then constructor method will call the. That means will call when calling the class. That means when you are calling the class, if you want to call the class, that means in this case I am calling the class here. See here. That means with the help of object, you can create the object. Now you are calling the class. At the time of calling the class, at the time of getting the class or calling the class, at the time of creation of memory, you will call the constructor method. That means at the time of creation of object, you can call the constructor method. If you create one constructor, then you can automatically know more about the constructor. Yeah, I'm going to creating the simple constructor. Let us assume here. How can you create the constructor? Important thing here. You can create the constructor by using underscore underscore init method, not just like a Java. Java having the same class name as a this one, not like that. Here it is a special method. Okay, I'm going to creating a simple constructor. How can you create the? For example, already create a class for student. Okay, I'm creating the some other class. For example, class name here is a. For example, I am taking employee class. Same variables and I am using employee class. In this employee class, I am going to defining the constructor. constructor is a one special method. Method, how can you defining the method? By using def keyword. Now I am going to declare the constructor. I am going to declare the constructor. How can you declare the constructor here? The constructor is a special method. That's why with the help of def keyword I can declare the constructor def underscore underscore. Automatically it came underscore underscore init method. For the init method also you pass the self. That means instead of previously I want to define in the method. How can you define the method def? Give a any name, but here I am using the underscore underscore init. Underscore underscore init, under this one I am going to declare in the some variables. Class variables. Here I am going to declare in the class variable. How can you declare in the class variables here? What are the different class variables in this case? Here, for example, I am taking the some, for example, in this case, I am passing some, the first value is a self is a parameter and automatically takes the, if you write the self, that means every method consists of self. Without self you cannot write any method. That means here this particular method belongs to this particular class. This indicates this particular method belongs to this particular class. Under this I am going to give a some id and then some name. Employee id, what is the employee id, and then employee name. I am taking these values. That means I am taking these values, and then here I am going to initialize the class variables. How can you initialize these particular class variables? You can initialize the class variable with self. self.id equal to id. And then for example, like in Java also you can declare a self variable. self.name equal to, let us assume name. These are the class variables and initializing here. I am going to initializing the class variables. In this case, I am initializing the different class variables. Okay, I initialize the class variables. Previously, I am taking the class variables directly. Now I initialized the class variables. Now I am going to define in the another function. For example, I am taking the another function as a, for example, display function. Let us assume display function. Under the display function I am going to print the this is a class. I am taking another print command. Print, how can you print these values here? For example, I want to print the id with the help of self dot id, and then print self dot name. Two values I am declaring here. Must see the difference here. Two values I declare here. Now okay, this part is enough. Same, that means I can explain the differences between a previous one and this one. Okay, I created a one in, that means how can you call the these particular variables? I can differentiate the difference between the class variable, local variable, and then global variable. Class variable, local variable, as well as the global variable, I can tell you the differences and okay, this is a way. That means I created a one constructor. Now I am going to call the constructor. I am going to call the constructor. Verify this one. What is the constructor? Using constructor, you can create a instance variables. Here, these are all are the instance variables. You can create the some instance variables, and then you constructor method will call when you call in the class. This method automatically call and that is the advantages of constructor. At the time of calling the class, automatically call the constructor method. No need to call separately. See here, this is a one method. This is a another method. This is a another method. Now I am going to creating the object. For example, O is an object. Let us assume O equal to. How can you create the object? You but with the help of class name and with parentheses. Now memory allocated for this object. Memory allocated for this class. Now what is the thing here? You have to call the constructor. Actually here without passing any parameter you can call the constructor. Here not having any constructor, that's why you are creating object like this. Now in this case, see here it indicates some error and why I'm adding the parameter id unfilled, parameter name unfilled. That means you have to pass the constructor variables. Here for example id equal to 56 and then name equal to Rama, like the hexa, name equal to hexa. Now there is no error at the time of creation of that means object. You can call automatically call the constructor. That means here initializing the class variables in this case. Automatically call this particular constructor. After that, I am calling the method. For example, o dot display. Then you can execute this one. You can get the result. Ma, what is this one? Verify this one. For example, underscore is a init. Underscore init is a one method. See here. This is a special method. This one is a method. And then this one. What is this one? This one also a method. But this method call you can call the this method with the object. Here you are calling the display method with the object. And then the constructor is there. You cannot call the constructor with the object here. At the time of creation of object, you call the constructor method. That means constructor method automatically called. That is a different. Will you identify the difference here? There very important thing in a constructor. In the particular constructor, you can call the this particular constructor. Like a constructor is a special type of method or function which is used to initialize the instance members of a class. Here if you comes to the Java and C++, the constructor name same as the class name, but it treats the constructor differently in Python. You can treat that differently in Python. How can you treat that one? Class student, here this particular it's going to create a particular object. That is a something about the constructor. The constructor called automatically when you create the object of a class. The constructor you can call the automatically. You have a non-parameterized constructors are there. Without parameter you can call the constructor. That means non-parameterized in the sense you are not passing any parameter for the constructor. Only one you can use the one parameter, and then you have a parameter non-parameterized in the sense non-parameter constructor uses when do not want to manipulate the value or constructor. That means it has only self as an argument. See here, that means if you remove this one, only one argument is there. Let us assume if you remove this one without also without any parameter also you can create the constructor. this is called without parameter, that is called here non-parameterized. That means in this way you can create the constructor. You are passing some parameter. This is called here parameterized constructor. The parameterized constructor, other one. The constructor has a multiple parameter along with self. Self common. Why? Because that is a method. Self is a common. That is a method. Here one default parameter also existed. For example, this is a parameterized constructor. This is a parameterized constructor. Here another important thing, default constructor. What is the default constructor? When do not include the constructor in a class or forget to declare it, then it becomes the default constructor. If not write any constructor value, that automatically, that means any particular class in Python here automatically have the default constructor. Default constructor. If you use constructor, this is a parameterized constructor. That is the difference, and that means it does not perform any task but initialize the object. That is a constructor. More than one constructor in a single class, is it possible or not? You can declare the two same constructor in a particular class. That means, for example, I'm having the, this is a one constructor, this is a one constructor. I can create a another constructor in this also. Here, I can create the another constructor in this also. Same names are there, but what is the condition here? If two same constructor in a class, the first method or constructor is not accessible by the object. Here, whatever may be the constructor, that means it's not accessible by the object. Here, you are accessing some constructor. For example, here I am using only ID. Here, I am using some name. Oh, let us assume the first constructor. This is a same name. What is the which constructor it will accessible? Here, the object cannot take this particular constructor. Whatever may be the constructor passed here, it will take the that particular object only. It will take that particular object only. See here, this is a way of representing the constructor. That means, see here, the first method is not accessible by the object. Internally, the object of the class will always call the last constructor if class having the multiple constructor. If it is having the multiple constructor, that means in the particular class you can create the more than one constructor. Like that means I am creating one constructor. With that particular constructor only I can access the value. That means I created the one constructor. Like that you can create the n number of constructor. Yeah, even though you can create the n number of constructor, whatever may be the last value, you can this particular object can access the last value for the constructor only it can access. That is a more advantages of the constructor. Okay, you can discuss this information after that. Okay, this is a way of creating the constructor. Here when I execute this one, you can execute this one. Ma, will you identify the difference between this particular class and this particular class? See here, without constructor I am writing this particular class. Without constructor, I wrote this particular class. With constructor, I wrote this particular class. Like that, you can create a student or any particular class. And here, for example, you can get the non-parameterized constructor also. You can get it. I can explain you what is a non-parameterized constructor. This is a parameterized constructor. If you want to know more information about the non-parameterized constructor, for example, what is a non-parameterized constructor? For example, I am taking the, let me take a simple class, copy, control C, control V, without passing any parameter here. For example, I am not taking this one, and then DEM, underscore init method I am taking here, not passing any parameter. Print I am taking, this is non-parameterized constructor. Non-parameterized constructor. After that, I can write something. I can write some value for that constructor. Here, you have a no need to call this one. Nothing was there. At the time of creation of object, the initially constructor will call. The best programmer in this particular case always use the constructor. That means in the companies also, you have to write. That means everything. That means you can initialize the variable. That's why you have to write the constructor for every class. You have to write the constructor. This is some difference between a ordinary class. This is a ordinary class without constructor. This is a particular ordinary class without constructor. This is a class with particular constructor. This particular constructor consists of some parameter. This is a non-parameterized constructor. This is a non-parameterized constructor. Okay, is it clear about the constructor? Is it clear about the constructor? Okay, if you clear, some of the built-in classes you can use. That means no need to know about this particular information. You have to clear the, for example, yeah. What is the, you have a doubt is there. Constructors are used to creating the class variables. What is the difference between a global variable, class variable, and then some other variables are there? Some global variable, what is a global variable? What is a class variable? What is a different, I have a doubt. You have a different doubt is there. How can you call the class variables? How can you call the global variables like that? Yeah, I can tell you. For example, any variable, global variable, let us assume, any variable declared here, for example, g, already I explained you global variables above the class. Any variable declares above the class, that is called here global variable. Global, at the time of functions, in the under the functions, I explain about the global variables, local variable. Local variable. Here, what is a local variable? Local variable is a variable you can declare under the function. For example, a equal to 10. A equal to 10. This is a local variable. This is a local variable. This particular is a local variable. This particular local variable, how can you create the local variable? The local variable accessible within a particular class only, but not a class, within a particular function. Outside the function, you cannot access the this particular. For example, you will print this particular A here. For example, print A here only. If you want to access the particular A, you cannot, for example, you cannot access the A. It gives some error. For example, if you want to access particular A, it gives some error. And then this is an error. You cannot access from the outside. This particular variable, you call it as a, you declare the variable in this case, this is called here local variable. This is called, you can access the global variable anywhere. From anywhere, for example, if you want to print, for example, G, let us assume G, print G, you can print it, no problem. But if you want to print A, you cannot print that one. Print A, let us assume, if you want to print A, it gives some error. See here, this is a error. Why? Because A is a global variable, A is a local variable, G is a global variable. Now, the third type of variables are there. What is the third type of variables here? Class variables. Yeah, the variables which are declared under the class. Here, for example, any variable, for example, let us assume salary. Salary equal to 5000, let us assume. Here, this particular variable, under the class, you can declare some of the variables. here how can you access these variables Sunday? Here any particular class variable you can access by using self keyword. Here for example I want to print this particular class variable. This is a class variable. See here, this is a class variable, this is a particular class variable. This one also, under that one you can declare the variable. This one also a class variable, class variable. That means how can you access this particular class variable? For example, I want to access the particular class variable. How can I access? For example, I'm going to print here class variable self dot class variable. What is the class variable? Salary. Self dot salary. See here, you can access class variable here. Not only that one here, you can access class variable here. Print self, it's not showing here. That means from here in the class variable, entire class, under the entire class you can access this particular class variable. But local variable you can access within a function. If you use another function, let us assume def show is a one function. If you want to access this particular a print a, it's not possible. Print a, it's not possible. But class variable you can access. In the particular entire class you can access the class variable self dot the particular class variable salary. Self dot salary. Not only here, not only that one, amma, here you can access the these variables also. Self dot id, for example, you can access print self dot id. You can access the id. Ma, is it clear? Is there any doubt about this one? Ma, three different variables you have. What are the three different variables? One is a the first one is a global variable. You can access the global variable anywhere in a module. The entire thing you call it as a module. Anywhere in the module you can access the global variable. And then coming to the class variable, in the entire class you can access the class variables. Entire class you can access the class variable. Coming to the local variable, the local variables are accessible within a particular, that means in this case a is a local variable. A is a local variable. You can access the a within a function, within a method only, not outside the method. You cannot access the local variable outside the method. Like that, in the Python you have a three different things you have. That is called here constructors. That's a simple information about the constructor. Okay, the next, already you discussed that one, more constructor values. Here we have the more than one constructor, is it possible or not? That means in the Python programming, is it possible? Yes, you can declare the more than one constructor. If you need, I can execute that one, amma. I can take any constructor, with that constructor I can execute. For example, more constructors. For example, take any one. Anything. For example, if you need more constructors, not a single constructor, I can take more constructors and then I can execute this one. For example, a particular class, in a single class, is it possible more than one constructor? Yes, it is possible. Yeah, more than one constructor in a single class, is it possible? Yes, it is a possible. Yeah, how can you do that one? A simple, I am taking the simple constructors. For example, same class. For example, class name, I am taking a simple class, for example, employee class. Not that class, you can take any name only. Here, for example, def, I am taking the one constructor, underscore underscore init underscore underscore init is a one constructor, and then print that value. For example, I am taking the first. The next I am taking another constructor here, for example def underscore underscore init underscore underscore init. Okay, not like this. Same name I am taking, same name I am taking for that one, same name. And then for this one I am taking the second, I am taking the second. Like that you can take the another constructor also. You can, that means in particular class you can declare the more than one constructors. For example, I am taking the another class, for example this is a third. This is a way, for example I want to create the object. For example, I am going to creating the object o equal to object equal to emp. I call the object. At the time of calling the object, you can create the constructor. Which constructor you are going to calling? See here, third. Ma, will you identify the difference here? Whatever may be the constructor you declared last with the same name, but data is different. With the same name you created, but data is different. Ma, is it okay? Anyone respond? Is it okay? The constructor values? Yeah, this is a, in this way you can create the three or more, any number of constructor in a Python program. And then some of the built-in classes for the constructor also available, some of the built-in classes here. For example, built-in class functions. How can you create the built-in class functions? What are the way for creating the built-in class functions? You can discuss that one. For example, some built-in class functions you have here. How can you, what is the first function? Get attr. Here, what is the get attr function? This function used to access the attribute of object, the particular attribute of object, the particular object attribute. You can get the this particular function. That means I can explain you how can you use those values. I can explain you the, now I can explain you the those values. For example, initially I am going to creating a simple function, simple class. Let me take any class, employee class I am taking. Under the employee class, for example, already this class I created, employee class. Okay, no need that one. You can take the any class. Okay, already I created this particular class. I am taking the only one constructor, let us assume. Under the constructor I am taking the some variables only. I may take the, for example, id is a one variable. And then
sir,
tell me ma.
Sir, could you tell me about attribute meaning, sir?
Attribute in the sense, these attributes only. Ma, please, I can execute one program, not a attribute method now, then you can understand. Okay,
yeah, okay sir.
I can call now, then you can understand. For example, name, age, like that I am taking these values. After that I am creating the self parameters. Now these variables are called as a class variables only. self dot, for example, id equal to id, like that. Self dot name, let us assume. No need. One minute, ma. Self dot name equal to name. Let us assume self dot, for example, let us assume age equal to age. Self dot age equal to age. Here I am going to creating one object in this case. I can tell you thus, how can you call that values. For example, I am going to creating some object. E is a one object. Okay, already created that one. For that one I am taking the, for example, 101 is a one value. Other, for example, other one is a hexa. Hexa is another value, and then some other value I am taking. That means why I am taking the three param. For example, 35. Age is a 35. Let us assume I am taking the three parameters now. Okay. I have taken the three parameters. When I execute this one, you can execute these values. Now you come into the this one. Here, what is the get attribute method here? This particular get attribute method used to, it takes a object. What is an object in this case? O is a one object. Let us assume O is a one object. It takes the object. Object is a one parameter, and then name comma default value. What is the condition here? Used to access the attribute of a object. For example, whatever may be the attribute you have, you can access the those particular attribute. Here, see here. For example, here now I am going to print the attribute name of the object. For example, I am going to print the attribute. Attribute name of the object. Here, what is an attribute name in this case? What are the parameters here? See here, the syntax is very important one. ATTR, get ATTR attribute name, and then you pass the object value. You pass some object. For example, it is a employee object. Let us assume object value I am passing here. For example, ATTR, that is a get ATTR. Already you have it will take the three parameter. One is a object value, another one is a name. For example, name I am taking. When I execute the, see here result. Okay, 1 minute. I need to get that value. You can have to print. See here. Ma, what is the condition here? Ma, is it clear? Attribute name of the object. This particular name. For example, if you want to print these values, you cannot print these values. Okay. Ma, is it clear? Ma, that person.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. That means this is a in the constructor. I want to get the attribute value. Any attribute, andi. I want to get the attribute value. If it is separately, you can declare the within a function. You declare the attribute. You can by using print command, you can get it. I want to get that value. For example, not only name and id. I want to get the id. You can get the id. In particular cases, you are using the attribute id. Next, set attribute. Verify this one. Syntax. You have to take the syntax value and then name. Same value parameter value. It is used to set a particular value for a specific attribute of object. For example, already it is having the ID is a 101 only. I want to set a particular value. How can you set a value of attribute? For example, take this one. It is used to set the value of this particular attribute. See here. Set the particular value. How can you set that one? Set attribute. SCT set ATTR set attribute. For example, already age 35 is there. I want to change that age as a 23. That means in this case, my condition is a change age to 23. How can you change that age to 23 here by using set attribute? Verify this one. One is a object. You have to pass the object. After that, name. That means what is the name of the attribute? And name means name of the attribute. And then value, which value you are going to setting, which value you are going to setting. Yeah, I am going to setting the, for example, E is a one attribute, E is a one attribute, and then for what I am going to setting here, for age, name same name, and then setting, for example, 23. I am setting already, see here, already age 23 is there. I am going to setting that particular age like this. Here when I execute this one, okay, remove this one, already this one, yeah, it will set the age. When I print this one, well, for example, already set that value, I set this value before that one. See here, before setting, let us assume, before setting, what is the age? See here, before setting, what is the age? What is the age? For example, e comma age, before setting, verify this one, 35, okay amma, before setting age 35. Now I am setting the age here. After setting, see here, after setting, what is the age? After setting, what is the age of the employee? Execute this one. See here, before setting, age is a 35 only. Okay, age is a 35. Now I execute the setting operation, setting function. After setting the age, when I am printing that one attribute value 23. My, is it clear about the get attribute and set attribute? Is there any doubt about this one built-in function? Yeah, not having any doubt. Then go to the delete attribute value. Delete attribute used to deleting a specific attribute. That means you can, if you I don't need any attribute. For example, some special cases, I don't need some of the attribute values. In particular cases, you will delete those values. How can you delete those values here? By using delete attribute. To delete, for example, I want to delete the age attribute. I don't need age. For example, for the employee, I don't need consider the age value. I want to delete the age. How can you delete the age? By using this function, del attribute. You will have the del attribute. See here, del attribute. For that one, what are the parameters? For that one, the parameter is object name of the attribute you are going to deleting. Object name is E. What is the name of the attribute here? I am going to deleting the age attribute. Let us assume, not only age, you can delete any attribute. When I execute this one, yes, remove, that means no need this one. Delete attribute, get attribute also don't need. Now I am going to deleting the age. When I execute this one, it will delete the age. Yeah, I am going to, you can print that value also. What attribute you are going to deleting? Print what you are going to deleting. For example, age, none. That means after that you can get that. See here, verify that one, whether that age existed or not. For example, I am going to print the age. How can you get the age? E dot, let me take age. E dot age. After deleting, see here, after deleting age value, see here, employee object has no attribute age. Now, is it clear? For example, before deleting, when I print the before deleting, before applying the delete operation, for example e dot age, e dot age. Now here there exists age, but here not having age. That means you can apply this type of operation only. This is a deletion, deleting the attribute. For example, before that there is a age is there. After applying the delete operation, there having some problem. That is a attribute age no value. That is attribute. And then other thing here is a has attribute. It returns true if object contains some specific attribute. It returns false if not having any attribute. For example, you can execute that one. How can you do that information? For example, what is the thing here? Has attribute. Okay, you can execute this particular has attribute. How can you execute this has attribute here? Same function, has attribute name. You can copy this one or you can get has attribute. What are the parameter you are passing? One first parameter object, other parameter is a name. Object is a, for example, is an object. For example, id is existed or not? Now id existed. When I execute this one, it will print true or false value. Okay, if it is a print, then you can get it print true or false value. If the id existed, has attribute id existed, it will print true. For example, instead of id, I am taking the id is there, name is there, age is there, and then salary not there. When I take the salary attribute, salary not there, that's why it gives a false statement. My, is it clear? All built-in functions. Is there any doubt about this one? Ma, okay na? If you clear, I can go for the next one. Some of the other kind of built-in class attributes available here. Some built-in class attributes here, for example, underscore dict. It provides a dictionary containing information about the class namespace. That means package is a namespace. A class namespace, in particular class namespace, it gives some values and dictionary values. How can you execute these dictionary values and for example same thing? Is it clear? Previous functions, how can you apply? Now these dictionary functions, how can you apply the dictionary functions on a variable? How can you apply these dictionary functions here? For example, you can dictionary, for example, for giving more idea here, this is a object creation. This is a creation of object. For example, if you may take the one method, any method, for example display method. I am taking the display method. Now I am using, for example, print. You can get the you can print the those values and it. For example, self dot id, I am printing these values, self dot id, and then self dot name, and then self dot for example age, self dot age. Three parameters are there. I print the three parameters. Okay, I created some object. How can you use this value sending? See here, first one, dict underscore underscore dict attribute. This particular attribute provides a dictionary containing the information about the class namespace. Verify that one. How can you get that one? For example, object dot underscore underscore, for example, dict, D-I-C-T, dict, underscore underscore dict. Here, for example, I want to see more information, you can use print here, print this one. If I execute this one, dictionary related information. What is this one? It provides a dictionary containing the information about the class namespace. Under the class namespace, you have a ID is there, name is there, age is there. You can get the all information as a dictionary format. As a dictionary format. Is it clear? Is there any doubt about this one? Similarly, underscore underscore DOC contains a string which has a class documentation. For example, I can execute same operations and for example, print, same operations I can apply. For example, underscore underscore DOC underscore underscore documentation. Yeah, when I execute this one, the first none is there. Nothing was there particular documentation. What it shows here, it contains a string which has the class documentation. Other same thing here, underscore underscore name, use it to access the class name. Underscore underscore module, underscore underscore module, use it to access the module in which class is defined. For example, you can take that one. Okay, for example, underscore underscore module, underscore underscore name, underscore underscore module, underscore underscore, if you get that one, see here, main module. Like that, and you have a some name, you can use name, for example, underscore underscore name, underscore underscore name, not showing, N-A-M-E, it is showing M-O. Underscore underscore, it not showing in the sense that the value is not there. I think you have a like that str, you can get the str function related information. You have like that ma, these are all are the different, not only restricted to these built-in attributes only. You have a n number of attributes are there ma. Is there any doubt about this one? If not having any doubt, then I can go for the next concept. Next concept, static method. Static method. What is a special name for the static method? You have a, this is a simple method. See here, this is called here instance method or something here. You call it as a, here this is a constructor method. This is a constructor, a special method. This is a ordinary method. Ordinary method itself, you call it as a instance method or something else. What is a static method? What is the main purpose of static method? What are the advantages for creating the static method? See here, in particular class, by using @ static method decorator, this is a keyword and decorate, that means you can discuss later, iterators, generators, decorator clearly. You can discuss next concept, you can clearly about the some decorator. First of all, you have to verify what is the special purpose. Decorator can create the static method. For creating the static method, you will use this particular decorator. For static method, self argument does not required. Here, for example, in the every case, in a constructor, you pass the self method. In this particular case, in particular method, or any method, you pass the self parameter. Without self parameter, you are not doing anything here. But in case of static method, you can, you does not require the this particular self keyword. And then what about the another thing here? Using static method, you can provide a same behavior to the all instance of a class, same behavior to the all instance of a particular class. That is a self, that is called here static method. And then another important here is a static method you can call by using instance or without instance. And here that is another advantages. For example, by using directly direct class name, you can call the this particular constructor. But for example, how can you call the constructor? How can you call the method? You can call the constructor with the help of object name. If the help of object name only, you can call the constructor. You can, I can tell you difference. If I execute the any program, then you can get the difference only. For example, this is a simple class. Now I am going to creating the one static method. For example, same class. For example, class name here we can I can take the one is a particular class name, first class. I am going to declaring the static method. How can you declare the static method here? Static method at the rate static method. Under this one, I am going to declare in the static method def. For example, add def. I am going to declare in the this method static method. Add under that, no need to get the any self parameter. Ma, is it clear? For example, in this case, you should pass the self parameter. That means this is a simple method. For this method, you pass the self parameter. But whereas in the static method, you did not pass any parameter. For example, I am taking the simple function and simple. This is static method. This is static method. And then now I am going to creating object. For example, O is an object. How can you create the object here? You can create the object by using one value, one this particular one parenthesis. In this way, you can allocate a memory. Just take in C++ new operator. With the help of new operator, you can create the object. Yeah, this is I created the object here. Now I am going to call this function or method. How can you call this method here? If it is a ordinary method, you can call this method with the help of object name o dot write. See here, o it is a ordinary method. That's why I am calling this method with the help of o dot write. Only then access. For example, if you execute this one, you can access this one. You can access. For example, this is a add is a one method. How can you access this add? How can you access? Why? Because this is a method o dot add. Yes, you can execute this one. But another way is there. Another way. For example, this particular static method you can accessible by using class name. For example, one. Take the class name. This is the name of the class. One is the name of the class. One dot add. One dot add. You can access this one. That's why this is a static method. For example, I want to access this write. For example, student dot write one. Is it executable? Error is there. See here. Some error is there. What is that one? Student dot write. Type error. Write one missing. Okay. Nothing was there. Type one missing required positional argument self. For example, you may pass some self for that one. It's give also a some error. Okay. But it's give some error indeed. Even though it works, but it gives some error. But here, with the help of class name, see here, you can access with object, and then see here another one. Access with class name. That is a more advantages of static method. That means so many number of times required the creation of static method. That means why? Because here static method you can provide a same behavior to all instance of a class, whatever may be the instance of a class, same behavior. That's why you are using this particular static. One advantage and the static method can access with the help of name or with the help of class name or with the help of object. In two ways you can access. But whereas in case of this one, you cannot access that one. And then the static method cannot take any parameter value. But any method, even though it is a constructor, takes a parameters. Even though it is a takes the parameter. Ma, is there any doubt about this one? Is it clear? Is it clear about this static method? If it is clear, then I can go for that one. Next one is a class method. What is a class method here? Using class method decorator, you can create the class method. Using class method decorator, you can create the class method. Here same, ma time okay, you can get it. That means tomorrow we will discuss this one, class method. Time already is 7:15, more 7:15, okay.